it's Jessie V.
Do you see my blonde hair poking through? I see it coming in, I see it.
All right, so in today's video, we're gonna be talking about a very creepy, creepypasta called Candle Cove. Now, I did very briefly talk about this creepypasta in a video about a year ago. I believe it was my Netflix glitch video, but I only talked about it for about 3 minutes. And since then, I always get requests to make a full detailed video on Candle Cove. So many people wanted to hear more, and it's actually quite fascinating. Before we get started though, just to remind you, we do have the new bath fizzies up on the website. Each of them have this really cool mysterious toy inside of it. So if you would like one, I've linked it down below. And we also have a brand new dragon plushie on the website. We've never had a dragon plushie before. It's called the Sunset Dragon. It's honestly so cute. So I've linked that down below as well. I literally collect so many plushies, guys. And like when it's a mythical creature, even better. All right, so let's get into the video. Back in 2009, people started talking about a show called Candle Cove that they remembered from their childhood, but no records of it actually exist. And it's actually crazy how many people remember watching this, but the show almost seemed to vanish off the face of the earth. It was kind of like a Mandela effect where 50% of people remembered watching it and the other 50% of people never even heard about it before. People remember it as being a very nightmarish show that aired in the 70s at 4 p.m. in the afternoon. So when they got home from school, they would immediately grab a snack and go and sit in front of their television. Now, it was made for kids, but every episode was super dark and disturbing. Candle Cove only aired for a few months, and it was about this little girl named Janice who imagined she was friends with pirates. The characters were all played by creepy marionette dolls, so it was essentially this show based on puppets. The pirate ship was called the Laughing Stock, and it apparently had this giant smiling face on the front of it, and the smiling mouth was so wide that it looked like it was swallowing the ocean as it glided through the water. And the weirdest part about the ship is that it could actually laugh, apparently. What people remember most though was this villain character called the Skin Taker, whose top hat and cloak appeared to be made of children's skin. And obviously, as a kid, that would be horrifying to see. Apparently, his mouth didn't open and close like it's normally supposed to, but instead, his jaw would just move from side to side as he spoke. I feel like that would be so hard to do. Let me try. Hi, my name is Jessie. People remember in the show, the little girl would go up to this skin taker pirate and would be like,
why does your mouth move like that?
And the skin taker would turn and look directly at the camera and would say,
to grind your skin.
So there were some very weird episodes that people remember. For example, one time there was one where the whole time the characters were just screaming and running around in circles for the entire 30 minutes. Another episode showed a huge mouth of a dark cave, and at the base of the cave, a creepy pirate marionette was talking to a little girl, but their voices were so muffled that you couldn't hear what he was actually telling her. And this went on for a full 30 minutes. It was almost like the show didn't really have a plot in each episode. It was just showing something very strange. There was this other character named Pirate Percy, and kids seemed to be really afraid of him as well. He looks like he was built from parts of dolls. It was like this show had a very low budget and was just trying to throw a character together. His head was an old porcelain baby doll, and it just looked like this antique that did not belong on his body. And apparently he wasn't a very good pirate because he always got scared so easily. There's also a character named Horace Horrible. He originally was the main villain of the show, but now serves as spy and servant for the Skin Taker, watching the pirates of the Laughing Stock, reporting to the Skin Taker about everything they do and obeying his every command. He has a black handlebar mustache, tall narrow teeth, a hook for a hand, and he wears a monocle on his right eye. It's unknown if he keeps his left eye or not. People think he may actually be a sorcerer able to summon creatures from other worlds. Now, I wanted to talk about the nightmares that kids would have after watching this show, which I feel like is really understandable. I mean, it was bizarre. They would be dreaming about the opening jingle of the show, and suddenly all the characters would appear out of the darkness, screaming for what seemed like hours and hours. There was this one account of a little girl who kept complaining about seeing the Skin Taker standing in her closet at night, just moving his jaw back and forth with a creaking sound. Imagine just like lying in your bed at night and just hearing a creaking sound over and over. It almost sounded like a chair to this little girl, but if she walked over to her closet, she would see him sitting in the darkness, moving his jaw back and forth, like, eek. That sounds like a horror movie sound. Okay, let's talk about the parents' perspective. Because when they would see their kids watching this show, it was just not normal. Parents that had kids back in the 70s remember walking into the room and seeing them sitting on the couch just watching static on the television for 30 minutes straight. And when they would go up and ask their kids what they were doing, the kids would say,
"I'm watching Candle Cove, Mommy. Look."
But literally all the parents could see was static. Some parents say they thought their kids were just making it up because they had a very active imagination. And people are just so confused. They're wondering if the show really did exist, was it just made up, or was it real but only kids were able to view it for some sinister reason? Like, was there really something supernatural going on about this television show? Now, before I go, I just want to say that this show really is just a creepypasta. I didn't want to like leave you guys freaked out or anything. It was first posted by Chris Straub and it went viral extremely quickly. I mean, this is probably one of the most talked about creepypastas, I think. Probably in the top 10 for sure. So I definitely wanted to make a longer video on it because I knew generally what it was about, but I had never like dove down and looked into more details. So if you guys know anything else that I did not mention, definitely comment it down below and comment what other urban legend or creepypasta that you want me to cover, because I love creepypastas. I really do. Before I get going, guys, don't forget, if you want to see my new puppy, I have him over on my vlog channel. We've been doing videos over there. He is so adorable. You guys have to see him, please. I've also linked the Bath Fizzies down below and our new dragon plushie. He's so cute. But I hope you guys have an awesome rest of your day and I will see you in my next video. Bye!